Hey everybody, welcome to this month's STEM program. So again, STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math. In the past we did some science experiments, but today we're going to be doing an engineering experiment. So on the calendar I put catapults, so I have a variety of popsicle sticks, different sizes to use today. And rubber bands, and then a couple other things that we can use. So I'm going to make mine today, but feel free to use whatever you have at home to experiment and have fun. So I'm going to just tilt down the screen and we'll get started here. So I looked at a few different examples, and I think I want to use these smaller ones to make my main bridge. We have like big, medium, and small here. I think I'm going to use a stack of small ones to make a stand, we'll say, or a brace, like this. Perfect. And then I'm going to use big ones for my top and bottom. So again, I just looked up online to see how people did it. So we've got one for the bottom and one for the top, and it's going to look like this. Okay, and then we're going to use elastic bands. Well, I guess we'll do this first. Use elastic bands to hold your main stack in place. Another one here. Perfect. You just want to make sure it stays nice and tight. Good. Or you could glue it if you really wanted to. All right, now it'll stay in place nicely for us. Okay. And then you probably want a little bit more room to brace it. Then you're just going to crisscross it over and make an X shape here. I don't know if it makes sense on the video, if you can really see what I'm doing, but okay, how do they do it? Okay, so then my issue is we have this side is up and this side is up, but we want to keep it so this side stays down so that this can properly fling stuff. So we need another rubber band at the very end here, and I'm going to get a bit of a thicker one. I think it wants to be a little bit stronger there. Make sure they're all the way touching. And then if you're using rubber bands to do it, it's nice that if it doesn't work the first time, you can adjust your design. All right. So a couple different edits that you can do here is if you have like a pop lid or any kind of lid, you can put it on the end. This one's a little bit deep. I don't know how that would affect the trajectory of the thing that I'm catapulting, but you could glue it to the end here, and then you put a little something in there that you're gonna shoot. So I have beads here, but you might wanna put like marshmallows or something like that in there. Having something to set it in is nice. You don't have to though, you could just do it like this. Or I'm going to use a plastic spoon today. So you just put that in there, and then, whoop, perfect. Okay, are you guys ready? I'm gonna see if it works. It worked. Perfect. So I hope you guys have fun making your own little catapult at home. Let us know what you experiment with. You can make the cross brace, you can make it with the thicker ones. That might affect how far you can shoot it. Let me know what kind of variations you guys do at home and what kind of stuff you're shooting with. And like, I really encourage you to set up like a distance parameter thing so you can see how far you're shooting them, see what materials go further, what if you do multiple ones, if the bigger one works better than a smaller one, different things like that. So yeah, have so much fun making this. And be nice to whoever you're shooting with them, preferably not people. All right, bye guys, have fun.